couple of really weird caution signs. Looks like he's dancing, doesn't it? Well, I'm randomly going somewhere to do Sunday Outside videos again. And this time I'm going as far west as possible on the Metropolitan Line, which is Chesham. For no reason at all, other than just to see what it's like there, because I've never been there before. So I'm going to Chesham. And I feel so far out of London, the signal on my phone dropped out twice. And so now it feels like I'm out in the country because there's lots of green trees. And this is Chalfont and Latimer. Because you had to get on the Amersham train and then stop off here to get the other one. So this is how far out of London I am. But all the way in Zone 9. So that I've had to go all this way around me, yeah, and that's how far I've gone. I had to go like that, and then and it's raining, which is great because I love the rain. Also, as well, according to Wikipedia, sorry, I'm chewing, that's so rude. I'm sorry, I'll get rid of this chubby soon. I don't normally chew. But according to Wikipedia, the distance from Chalfont and Latimer Station and Chesham is the longest on the underground without any stops. You know, the longest non-stop journey is from here to Chesham. So, yeah. Look at that. Seems to go on forever, just green.
Customer service updates. Apart from today's park closures for engineering works, there's good service operating on all lines.
Oh, that's good. I love the sound of the rain, don't you? I'm going to get on the back of the train because hopefully there'll be nobody there, and there is one person, but it doesn't matter. I'm going to get on the back because I'm going to read some of your comments.
Well, on the way to Chesham, you can see lots of green whizzing by me. Oh, is it that way? Yeah. Is it? I don't know which way to go to be honest. I'm just going to do one, which was Sunday Outside last week, which was slow to the run up. You know, when I try to do all the roping. So look, Kerrigan, this is hilarious. Just on Friday, I bought right guard for the first time. And I don't buy right guard anymore. Jay Phantom's put first. Did just free time copyright trademark is put. For that train, they could have gone to Poundland for the cleaning stuff. Yeah, that was from the week before last. It was when I was commenting on the outdated Northern Rail trains was. They sent me a Twitter. They said, oh, which train was it? And that was last year. So they didn't care. Ellie Nichols was put, wow, what is going on? What is going to be next healthcare on plan? I'm sorry. I should have watched last week's video again, just to know what I said. Yeah, the brand's put, hat sounds like a great copy slag in the background. And James Griffiths put, 5 smiley faces. So yeah, so from Chalfont and Latimer Station to Chesham is the longest non-stop journey on the London Underground network. I think I've said that already, but I think I've just made it more clear. Unfortunately though, the new trains are louder. The older trains, which were comfier as well, were quieter if it wasn't near the motor of the train. You could probably hear it in the background. It's just constant whirring sound because all the cars are powered, I think, all the train carriages. But on the older trains, there wasn't.
Ooh, look at that. Hills. Nice, isn't it?
If I held the camera straight, you'd have appreciated them a bit better, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I've got quite a way to go, so that's one video done.
Nearly there. I hope there's something there. No parent come all this way out and there's absolutely nothing in Chesham. That would be really a big letdown, wouldn't it?
Well, it appears that I'm here, and I don't know quite why I'm wearing a hood under a brolly. We're at Chesham, so we're officially the furthest out of London using the tube, and we'll find out how much it cost me as well. Now, I did put a fiver on my Oyster card, so I'm hoping that's enough. So obviously I used to live in Uxbridge, didn't I, but I've never been this far out because this is on a completely different line, and since I'm doing Sunday outside at different ends of the line, I thought I might as well go as far as I can. I wonder if this is one of the ones that'll tell me on this bit that how much it cost. Oops. Ooh, seek assistance. Why? Ugh. £4.10. Scandalous. Okay, so I've just left the station and this didn't look good. It looks like just a load of houses and some fields and oh, there's a bird. I've all come up to the middle of nowhere. I'm starving as well, I need to find something to eat. Is that a Waitrose? Oh, found a Waitrose in the distance. Civilization! Oh, it's raining. I found the High Street, but it's quite dead. There's quite a lot of hairdressers and charity shops and shops that are closed for the bank holiday. It is Bank Holiday Sunday, so it is going to be very quiet, but this is it. And that is a Sainsbury's. So I've just been into Waitrose, bought some peanuts, some cheese and a bottle of Coke. And I could have gone to Sainsbury's and could have got something else, but hey-ho. I'm a bag broke when I was in Waitrose. I had to knot the handle back together. Yeah, Isle of Entertainment. This bag was free when I bought the phone. So you just can't get quality for free, can you? Anyway, I did the video about Made a Most Already, didn't I? So the comments on this was, I just discovered the first series of Rent a Ghost on DVD. It was amazing, said Craig Tiffany. I've never seen that. Don't know what it's about, I'll have to look into it. Samantha Williams put, I never got into this, but I feel like after watching this video that I need to maybe re-watch Friday Girl and give it a chance. I really think you should, Samantha Williams, because each episode was written by different people and the characterisation was different. So if you watched the first few and didn't like it, there's going to be at least one, maybe two episodes per series that you'll like. I love AbFab. I never missed an episode. Wish it would make a comeback. Charlie, love you, sweetie. Bye. Oh, thank you very much. Naomi Klinker has put, just ordered the complete box set. Can't believe I've never heard of this. Well, that's pressure now. I hope you enjoy the series after I've just bigged it up. But I do love Made a Most Already, and I've watched so many episodes since doing this video. Mark Smith put, what about Murder, She Wrote? My wife enjoys watching this. Ah, you see, the thing is with Murder, She Wrote, sometimes it really bugs me, especially at the end where Jessica Fletcher always finishes the episode with a stupid grin and it's always on a freeze frame. She'll just go, and she'll be looking at it. It always seems to be the same finish. Some episodes of Medishore are really, really good, especially the one where the doctor dies and it was a two-part. Well, no, he didn't die, did he? Was it a doctor? Well, anyway, it collapsed after eating an apple. Jessica Fletcher had some sort of weird, sort of stalkery woman trying to copy her work and everything, and it was a two-parter. That was a really good episode, but otherwise, nah. Not really into Murder, She Wrote as much. I do like watching it to take the crap out of it sometimes. Because she just comes up with information sometimes, and you're thinking, she can't possibly have known that. And since it ran for so long, you know, it was, how could people just not know who she was? Mark put, just watch it on YouTube. It is available on YouTube, yeah, Metamo Story. But the thing is, because it's been chopped up, you lose the suspense in some of the episodes, and you lose some of the jokes. And then Nicholas says, but please could you explain what your experience was like on X Factor? Love, Ellie. Love. Thank you very much, Ellie. I did audition for X Factor for many years. And the reason for that was, it would have been nice, obviously, to get as far as possible, but I knew I wasn't ever going to win, because no one can. And anyone who says that, I'm lying. There is two parts of the show. There's the TV show and there's a music show. And I did loads of open auditions to get over nervousness of auditions, because I was doing proper auditions as well, but things like X Factor and Big Brother, which I also did, Britain's Got Talent, quiz shows even. There was really good ways to get into an audition process and get used to talking to complete strangers and either doing a performance, like for a proper audition, or in quiz shows, it was just a great way to meet new people because you never know who's who. You know, that's why you should always be nice to everybody, because you never know who is going to be somebody one day or who knows who. So it's really important. So my experience on X Factor was, it was all over the place. Sometimes it was really good, sometimes it was really awful. Like when we went to Leeds, it was an audition in Leeds. No one got through that year. And I've mentioned this a few times before. I think the reason why they did that, no one got through, is because the TV production company probably lost a lot of money, because we wouldn't stop booing the production team for saying no to this guy who was singing opera, and he filled the stadium with his voice. He was amazing. Everyone cheered because he was so good, and he got a no, and it was just constant booing, to the point where someone actually got onto the tannoy of the stadium and said, oh, can you stop booing, because we've got loads of other stuff to, you know, at the beginning episodes we got, oh, ring up the X Factor, where he was meant to be doing all that, and we didn't. And because we was too busy booing, because we couldn't believe this guy was told no. And so we think they threw the toys out the pram, the production company X Factor on that one, and put nobody through from Leeds as some sort of punishment, which wasn't very fair. But it wasn't very fair the way they treated that dude. So that was that video. Next one is I Ate Tory Wide Standing. This is so dead. I think everybody in Chesham has disappeared off the face of the earth. Well, apart from a few people in the background and me. No, I'm not in prison. Let me out! I'm stood underneath some sort of clock that Chesham Society 1993 Award. So I'm presuming it was built somewhere in the 90s. And it's meant to look older than where it is. You'll see a picture of it in a minute. God, the rain's just flying in at the side, so I'm not particularly very dry at the minute. I might still need my brolly. Brolly up. There we go. So the next one was I Ate Tory Wide Standing. Luke Carrigan put, don't watch enough politics to comment. You don't need to. It's usually on the news or something like that. Really, really irritating when they do it. Legs overly wide, and they usually got the chest sticking out. And usually the buttons on the shirt not done, the colour buttons, and the suit jacket buttons will usually be all undone. You did a review of that Crave Roulette, by the way, and you forgot all about on the week before last Sunday outside. I know, yeah, it's because I've done over 2,000 videos. I have forgotten a lot of what I've done. Sometimes it gets to the point now where if I buy something to review, or if I'm saying something, I have to look back to make sure I've not done it already, and if I have, not said it too many times, like with my pronunciation of the letter H. I think I've done 4 separate videos on that. And Alan Murphy 647 put, dear Charlie, I love Don French and Made a Most Storage. My favourite episodes are Everyone Hates Granny, Frozen Breakfast at Tiffany's, and all of the episodes. It's so hard to choose. It so is. It's weird that you've commented without comment on this video, though. Mam's Tavern to put. They stand like that so we have more area to spit at them. I know, yeah, it is some like, it's like something like they used to do in the 1970s. That's what they used to do to stars back then. They used to spit at them as a sign of appreciation. Disgusting. Elizabeth M.E. Warren put, I found the start of this video quite funny. Thank you very much. Luke Carrigan put, just so I can hear you say it again, wrong. Wrong. It's the wrong way to stand. Thuggy has put, most of them from all parties do it like the hands on their hips. Oh, I have no tie. Oh, hang on a sec. Most of them from all the parties do it like the hands on the hips. Oh, I have no tie on, open shirt, the man on the people's shot, all bloody stupid looking, to be honest. Yeah, it's not just a Tory thing, but they are the most prolific for doing it. Jay Phantom's about, haha, it's because they're pissed. I hate Charlie Fleming, Tiny Willie in brackets. How did you know? And Mam's Davids put, the old bidders across the road must be loving seeing you in the garden jumping about, lol. P.S. Mrs. May can't stand like that because her knob might fall down and reveal what we already know. She's a bloke. She's done it, though. She's done it. But she tried doing it in some sort of pencil skirt, I think she was wearing at the time. And it looked really super-duper awkward. If you look up, if you can bear to have it on your search history on your computer, I think it's probably the worst thing you could have, is Theresa May Tory wide standing, and you'll see the picture. It looks so awkward. And Mark put, it's because they're pissed. Probably. They have no concepts, do they, of the real world. So I'm going to move on again. Hello. Someone's doing the thumbs up. And we're going to move on. Oh yeah, I need to show you the clock that I'm stood under. And there's a weird DIY homeware shop behind me with no name that probably locally has a name, but it's just not written on in there. Not that I could see anyway. I'm going to go and have a look back and see where it says. It's open though, because most of the shops are beginning to shut now, because it's about 4:30, I think. I'll have to look at the time. Yeah, it's 4:10, and it was built in the 90s. The bricks for this tower were donated by H.G. Matthews Bricklayers. Restoration of the original clock faces was a gift from Mrs. Anne Evoker. Oh, no. Oh, that's unfortunate naming. Either that or our parents had a sense of humour. Town Mayor, 1990-1991, in memory of our husband, Peter Rucker. Oh, no, it was just unfortunate marriage. Oh, no. I think she could have done with that. That is hilarious. Oh. So, flooding in Chesham. Why and where it happens. And apparently it floods in Chesham. Because by the looks of it, it was built on some lower ground. So there we are. If we get it in shot, you can read it. So you can press pause and read it. If you're interested in this kind of thing. Now, what I have noticed about Chesham is it seems to have a lot of banks and building societies. With the exception of NatWest, which has closed down. There's also a lot of closed down shops, which suggests to me there's a lot of people with money in Chesham that just don't want to spend it. So we're going to have a look at that shop now, which seems to have no name. I don't know what that's about. It's just a shop. I feel like I want to buy something from there, just so I know the name of the shop. Anyone can have fish. Trademark, it says there. Can you see that in the middle? That's weird. It's just a shop. It's just a shop. That is really weird. Right, where else can I go? Everything's closed. I mean, I know it's a bank holiday Sunday, but surely this must be somewhere to go. I have no idea where I am now. I don't know if that is just for this little bit here. Oh, look. Some sort of park thing. Geese. Oh. I wonder if they mind that it's raining. This is a big pond. Oh, finally I found a park or something. There is something here. This looks really nice. Right, let's get under one of them things. Oh, I could do more of your comments. I'm getting rain on my camera. It's a good job I saw this, otherwise I'd have fallen right in it, wouldn't I? Oh, well, this looks nice. I wonder what there is. This green space. Now, should I send under the green thing over there and have the ducks in the background? Or should I go under the old one and have the ducks in the back? There's a bench on that one underneath. That means I can sit down and read your comments and have the... Okay, so that's a big one, isn't it? That's just shaking its feathers there. Let's see if I can zoom in without my umbrella flying away. I've got that one there, look. What the size of that? Christmas dinner sorted, wouldn't it? Does that shake your head? That's what everyone's thinking. See, even that duck laughed. Highly suspicious of me, this one. Keeps looking at me. Very suspicious of me. Look, it's trying to pretend it isn't now. Yeah, I'll just itch my nose. Or beak, whatever. Supermarket market share 2020. Supermarket market share. I've only just realised I've said the word market in the title twice. Too quickly. And, I'm not sat down because the bench is soaking wet. The floor's dry, but the bench is wet, so I can't sit down. Is that wind going to be on the camera? I think it is, isn't it? So if I twist it this way, like that, then I shouldn't get any, yeah. James Gooden, please do a part two. Well, I will do. I mean, when it gets to the end of 2020, if I'm still alive, you know, life happens. You know, I could get run under a bus. I mean, I could be doing a Sunday Outside video somewhere random and not look where I'm going. That's the biggest risk of filming out in the public, not looking where you're going. You know, you see people walking around on the phones not looking where they're going. Well, this is just as bad. So yeah, James Gooden, I will do a part two to that video, and we'll see what happens with the supermarkets in just over 2 years. Look, Harrigan, put whatever happened to that chocolate series you were doing, you're going to do, but never made a second episode. I'm sorry, Luke Carrigan. I am sorry. I know, I think I did white chocolate, didn't I? I need to go into dark chocolate. I can't remember which one I did. I do need to do it. I've lost the titles to that series, so I'm going to have to redo them as well. And I will do it. I will. I don't know when, though. But I will do it. I know I'm terrible for starting stuff and never finishing it. There's different things happen, and sometimes I just forget. Sometimes I do just forget. City West Island's world class business campuses, but they should leave it all alone. Yes, they should. But they won't. Matt put great video, thank you very much. Breadcrumbs has put the Asda Red office in Leeds is due to be demolished for HS2 in a few years. I didn't know that. So it wouldn't surprise me if they use that as a convenient excuse to move everything to London. They will move everything to London. Sainsbury's is based in Oban, but because of the cost of property, I can imagine them moving both the head offices to somewhere cheaper. A bit like Tesco, and it used to be in Chesham, and they've moved it now to Welwyn Garden City. They'll move it like just outside of London enough so that they're in London enough. S125 is just breadcrumbs. Has the route been confirmed though? It doesn't really matter though, does it, S125-ish? Because they'll use any excuse to close anything down, whether it goes through or not. Sometimes stores don't even have to open. Look what happened in Ilinden, where there's meant to be Morrison's and a Tesco opening. Then in the end, neither of them did. And the pub got saved again. Luke Harrigan put, interesting to see if you're right about Asda Sainsbury's. I've replied to this one in person. And I put, they'll take up, this is what I put. I'm having to read it like this. They will overtake Tesco for a very short while, but I think they'll drop down again. When Morrison's overtook Safeway, there was major problems with the accounting, causing Morrison's to issue its first ever profit warning. There are going to be many duplicated distribution centres which will close, and stores, and I think this will affect customers' loyalty, especially when they don't get the 10% saving as promised. That is what I replied. That's what's going to happen to Sainsbury's and Asda. Once they've merged, they're going to close duplicated distribution sites because they're one of the first things to close because they're really expensive to run and they're really important to be in the right location. As well as stores as well, and then the head offices. It's going to lead to a load of job losses, and let's not forget this promise of you're going to save 10% on your shopping, because we're not going to get it. We are not going to get it. That's just reminded me of another video that I want to do, actually, about why you do not want to get a smart meter. I learned it off bigclav.com. If you watch his videos, if you subscribe to him, you'll know why getting a smart meter for your electric is probably going to end up being a really bad idea for you, because the energy companies are going to be able to flick a switch and they're going to be able to charge you more for your electricity by using the smart meter. So I'm going to get my information right about that though first, because I want to make sure that I'm right in what I'm saying, because I am not an electrician, so I don't know the actual fundamentals of it, but I'm going to investigate into it and see what it is actually going to happen, because the government are involved, obviously, because they make money out of it still, you know. Contracts and all this, that and the other. I mean, the politicians have shares with the electricity companies and this, that and the other. They have no responsibility to us, it's for himself. It's still getting a bit of rain on me. I'm going to do one more video here and then I'm going to move on and see where else there is. There's a slide over there. If only it wasn't raining. Oh, it's windy. I hope this isn't interfering with the sound. We had thought about plastic. Andrew Ricks has put, plastic is made from oil that's been underground for millions of years. I wonder if in millions of years, pardon me, sorry, just belching then. It's because I've not eaten. I went to Waitrose, but I've not actually eaten any of that stuff yet. I'm starving. Plastic is made from oil that's been underground for millions of years. I wonder if in millions of years, whatever life is on Earth will be digging up plastic and making something else of it. That's a good point, Andrew Reeks. It's a really weird way of people digging up, like, random discarded Fisher-Price toys and this, that and the other. Or the plastic, like, plastic bottles and stuff. James Gooden's put, I have those big Aldi bags and they hold up pretty well. We always use them and rarely forget. Yep. I forgot about this plastic. I mean, this! Two knots I've had to tie in the handle now to tie it back together, and I still don't trust it anymore. I mean, that's going to be cluttering up the bloody environment, although I think that's that kind of papery sort of stuff. It's not plastic as such. But it's still a waste of resources. Tracy Weir, or Tracy Ware. So I hope I've pronounced it right. I think about that kind of stuff too. I was told that it takes hundreds of years for a single toothbrush to decompose. Holy night, do you know how many toothbrushes are thrown away? P.S. Your channel brings me joy. T. Thank you very much. I've got an electric toothbrush, and the many things that are thrown away. I've thrown away loads of them, and normal toothbrushes, obviously. And Oral-B as well, still send out them little tiny little plastic things, different colours on that. I think they're meant to be so that different members of your family can use the same toothbrush handle, or to remind you to swap your toothbrush head or something. Complete waste of plastic. Really silent it down with rain now. I think the ducks are happy about it, but I'm not too sure. You can't even see them. I can't see them on this LCD screen. There they are, look. Can you see them now? Yeah, you can. So what else am I going to read? Should I just like stick my nose in like this so you know that I mean? Just keep reading the comments out. Or maybe just my eye. Scary zoom. Elizabeth M.E. Warren, I'm going to have to move the camera back because of the wind. I need the wind to be blowing in my face. There we go. Hopefully that's solved now. But it's not a fun background, is it? It's just a hill. Is that some kind of basketball thing? It's unusual. Elizabeth and me were put. I just shove a lot of crap in them, to be honest. First, random stuff in my room, then off the bin, black bin, blue bin, or whatever, brown bin, grit, Charlie. Exactly. I mean, you can try to recycle as much as you can, but I mean, there's always going to be somebody who whinges. And then look what happened in the news story a while ago about all the recycling that was just shipped off to some random country and just dumped in landfill there. You know, you can't win, can you? Charlie Brown's put, it's great that plastic has been used less in 99% of cases, but I find new straws horrible to drink from. Had a slush the other day and the crap straw almost ruined it. Gonna stockpile on plastic straws before they disappear. Might get some reusable curly straws. I used to love those as a kid. Yeah, but it's washing things like that, and there's also a problem as well with metal straws because they can chip your teeth. And I was watching a news report the other day about disabled people that actually need plastic straws, and good ones as well. Like you say, some really rubbish plastic straws about, aren't they? Because obviously they can't drink from a cup or a glass, so they need a straw. I don't think they'll disappear completely, but I do think that they are being sold too cheaply. And we need to be... Oh, gosh. Really chugging it down my rain. And we really need to find a way how to price straws properly so that they're good quality ones that you could reuse a few times. Like, the curly straws are a good idea, but it's washing them out. You need to make sure that they're really thoroughly cleaned because bacteria can build up in them. Wow, it's got really windy. I should really keep an eye on the time. I could get stranded out here. I never even thought of that. I'm so used to living in central London. Where you can get on a tube train every 2 minutes. Yeah, I need to keep an eye on that. Mam Stafford, plastic is a great invention, but it's going to eventually suffocate us. Man is his own worst enemy. You see, oh, all the ducks are jumping into the water. I think it's because the dog's coming. You see, that's just the thing, you know, when you get all these environmentalists, like the really full-on environmentalists, and they're like, oh, everything we do is bad, and oh, we're killing the world, and blah, 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 blah. I don't think that the human race is here forever, so I'm just straightening my camera up, because I think it's on a... I think it's on a slant. Yeah, it is. Oh, well, I'll finish up. I'm not ashamed to be a human. I'm doing my best, but unfortunately, humans are messy people. We dig stuff up, we throw things away, we make a mess. So I don't apologise for being a human, so I'm not too bothered about... Oh, it's a dog. I ain't too bothered about what we throw away and this, that and the other. I mean, we can try our best, but we aren't going to be here forever, so might as well just live and let live. Reese Gowdercourt's put, interesting thought. I'm sure a solution will be thought of soon. I don't think it's an Oral-B's... Procter & Gamble's best interests. They just want to make the money. JJ's Free Time copyright trademark has put, yeah, you're 100% right there with that one. There's so much we throw away that vilifying things like straws and this, that and the other is not really having much of an impact. It's really weird because I'm in two minds. Yeah, I don't like creating waste. I do hate waste because it makes a mess. Unfortunately, we're human beings. Oh, I've just brought my folder out. Can I not get through today without breaking something? See, look, that's going to be thrown away. I ain't going to keep this. And how do I recycle this? I mean, that's plastic and paper and metal. You see, we're just messy. That is what it is. And eventually the human race will die off. And probably the whole world will sigh a great big breath of relief. Next video is Hammersmith Bridge. Oh, according to this, Aylesbury is 14 and a half miles that way. Oh, I'm encroaching on Food Review UK's patch now, aren't I? Hammersham's that way, 3 miles. Gerrard's Cross, 13 miles. It's weird because I still feel close to London now that I've seen this sign. Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? Well, it looks as if I've missed out on some sort of jazz band. It's been cancelled because it's too wet, apparently. It's too... Oh, let's see if I get my foot around this way to be able to see. Look, cancelled because it's too wet. Well, I've got a brolly. Surely you can have a jazz band in the rain. What is it? A jazz band, yeah. Cancelled today. Sorry, too wet. Exclamation mark. Shocking. It's actually quite nice round here, actually. I'm underneath that green thing. But it's absolutely useless. It's not sheltering anything from the weather at all. I'm not doing any comments here because it's just too rainy underneath this green thing. But they could have held it anyway. They could have got some tarpaulin or something. And, oh, well, that's just too much good idea, really, isn't it? Somebody needs to tell these ducks about this deep water. It's deep water, ducks. It's deep water. Get out. It's deep. Read the signs. Rude duckers, they're not even listening to me. Outrageous. They tried to do the nice thing. Look where I'm all disobeying me. How dare they defy me. There's the shop no name again. The bag split on me. Again. So, I got this. It does look quite, well, old person-ish really, doesn't it? But do you know what? It works. It's got a zip on it as well, so I'm just glad because my camera was beginning to get wet and all your comments was beginning to get wet. I was only going to get knocked over by that car and get wet. But, so much better I'll be able to carry my stuff now. I'm just going to pop my stuff down on this bench. Is there any hilarious name on this bench? No. H.J. Baines. So, on the subject of what I was just talking about litter, this is going to be clearing up some sort of landfill for the next couple of years. So, Bag for Lives don't work.
On that note, when did Bag for Lives stop being called Bag for Lives and just getting called reusable bags? Eh? When did that happen? You used to always say, didn't it? Oh, don't forget your bag for life. Well, I think I'm going to back to station now. And, do the rest of your comments from there, because trying to find dry places to do your comments is getting a bit difficult. But yeah, this was Chesham. It's quite nice actually. I definitely think you should come and have a look if you're wanting somewhere that's got a field with some ducks and a pond and a park and a few shops, even though quite a lot of them are closing down. But then again, Millets is been on the verge of closing down for years. It's not always like this, I'm sure. This is just because it's bank holiday weekend, so everyone's gone off on holiday, that's all. Yeah. Apparently there's quite a lot to do around here, and it looks like it's really nice. That's terrible English, looks as if it's really nice, I should have said. Got on the rest of your comments in a minute. Walkers are welcome. Well, what happens if people like Seabrooks or KP Crisps? And there's a missing cat goes by the name of Roy. So if you've seen Roy, it belongs to someone in Chesham. Let's see how much I've got left on my oyster. 5:20, I've got, I can get on. Just waiting for the train now. And by the looks of it, there is no board to tell me when it is ever going to be here. So all I know is that I'm there. Well, yeah, it seems quite nice here. I wouldn't want to move here though, it's so quiet. But I suppose if you live in London and you want to feel like you're out in the countryside, I suppose this is the place you go. Hammersmith Bridge, AZ put, truly a sad chapter for that poor old bridge. I know, yeah. A bit of paint is all it needs. A bit of varnish. Samantha Williams has put, such a shame. Is it the black sheep of London's bridges? It's an insult to the craftsmanship and hard work that went into building this bridge. What a shame. I know, because you can clearly see how much work has gone into that bridge. And James has got to put, yeah, we had a bridge like that in Maidstone. It was closed for 9 months. And it was went from a right mess with potholes and patchwork. So a really nice, modern, bright bridge. Hopefully Hammersmith will get a similar repair. That was quite a lot. That's quite a lot of bruh words. Modern bright bridge. Roman Simpson's put, used to walk over that bridge to school every day towards Barnes. Good memories.
Was it as such a mess back then as it is now? You don't say how old you are. I mean, you're probably like 18 or something. Did you just read Tom's put? Where has the tax gone? Exactly, clearly into green gaffer tape. It's terrible. I can't believe they used gaffer tape to fix a bridge. I mean, at least with Lego, you'd put more effort into fixing it, wouldn't you? Feels like I had to be really, really quiet because there's only a few other people at the station, and we're just all waiting for the train, and it could be any number of minutes. Oh, it's sliding down. I've got the tripod, like, balanced between my legs because I don't want to put it down on the floor because it's soaking wet. Oh, it's here. I thought I'd be waiting for years. So there's only one more video to comment on, and that was the Yearn Base review, and then I've done it, and that's Sunday Outside completed. As it is a bank holiday, usually for whatever reason, these videos always upload really late. I'm going to try and find a quiet part of this train now to the end. So we're going to end this video here, with the last video. Samantha Williams was the first person to comment on the Yearn Base review video. I put, whenever I've shopped in Yearn Base in the last few months, I've noticed how friendly and helpful the staff are. B&Q, not as helpful. That is on the shop floor. Tell the staff I all usually helpful and friendly both stores, but I've noticed how Home Base will really bend over backwards to help, whether it's to search for something in the store or offering to carry your goods to the car if heavy. B&Q would probably do this, but you have to find someone and ask. Home Base are a bit more observant and attentive. Could just be the store that I use, but very friendly staff. This is the Home Base in Bishop Auckland in County Durham. I don't really use B&Q much now. Well, it feels like this camera's really close. I think what also helps as well is that Home Base is actually smaller, isn't it? B&Q's are usually massive. And but I do like Home Base more for that because, I really hope they pull through this horrible turbulent time. Rapture24GL's put, a couple of months back I needed some special light bulb for my bathroom. B&Q wanted £5.79 for one. I got a two-pack in Home Base for £2. None of the Home Base stores up here have changed to Bunnings, and some still have got an Argos in them. Exactly, yeah, because Argos will now be paying Home Base to be in them shops. I think it makes sense because it'd be like a concession, so they probably will be paying for that space. GGS 3 times put, I do not mind Home Base, but I wish Home Base was cheaper than it is. It also, I wish it would stop conning some people into the prices. I remember going ages ago into Home Base, so it's kind of sad to see it go if it goes. There's loads of potential in Home Base, and I think it needs to really grasp hold of that. Luke Carrigan's put, I was going to say when we need someone to show how to cook, but we already have that, I just haven't been bothered to look. I think I meant to say look before. Luke Carrigan's put, didn't say scrass at the end, 3! Yes, I did. I watched that video 3 times because of the edit. I had to make sure that it had edited together properly. I did say scraps. Although, you are right, I do sometimes forget. Max Smith put, did you buy anything? I didn't that time, no. I should have done, but I didn't. I've got no money, I'm waiting for payday. Ellie Nichols has put, it's a nice shop just like you. Thank you very much. And thank you to all for scrassing. Thanks for watching. Scrass, let me know in the comment section down below about any of my videos. And this bag that I bought from that shop that's nameless smells of it. It smells like it had been in that shop a long time. It's got that fusty sort of smell. I can smell it right now when I'm on a train. Well, I don't know when it's going to set off, but it's nice and quiet. Well, it will be when I stop talking. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to finally get round to eating some peanuts. I've already had like a few, but not very many at all. I'm starving. And I've got some cheese. And I've got some have a look. Just in case anyone thinks it was something else, no, it's the bottle of fizzy pop. I don't say fizzy pop. Do you say fizzy pop? I don't. My feet are soaking. And you know when your skin goes really itchy between your toes because your feet have been that wet for that long. Anyway, thanks for watching. Scress. There's probably going to be some end bits of filming, so see you when I see you. Bye. I've forgotten how sleepy the Metropolitan Line makes me feel. Because obviously it's all, well, nearly all of it, is purpose built, you know, back in the 1800s. It's all the railway lines are really straight. It doesn't twist and turn very much at all. So it's got this gentle swaying of the train. And especially before the older trains, before the tannoy announcement things used to call out every station, you could easily fall asleep. And I used to, fortunately, living in Nillenden meant that if I fell asleep and ended up in Uxbridge, it didn't matter because I could just walk back. It made no difference. But it does make a difference now, because if I fall asleep on this train now, I'll end up in Aldgate, which is in central London. But look, I'm hardly moving at all. Look, there's no twist and turning at all. Just...
on a normal train.
I bet I'm not the first to do this, but I think I've started off a trend. I hung my umbrella up off one of the grab handles because it was wet and kept falling on the floor with a stupid clatter. Someone's copied me. Look. I'm a trendsetter. Never understood about Arrow on the Hill is why it needs to have so many hyphens between each of its words. I mean, Arrow on the Hill. Well, if you want to make it all one word, make it all one word. If you don't, don't. No need for all these
hyphens. The next station is Arrow on the Hill. Change for Metropolitan Line services to Uxbridge and National Rail services.